The speech. I haven't got a lot of time to say anything. I will let my mehman visitors, because they have traveled a long way. We have a beautiful personality, Maulana Usman Saab Naqshbandi, has come all the way from Birmingham. He does a job as well. He finished his job, changed his clothes, and come all the way to Huddersfield. Just to say a few words, a message. I would like to thank you again. Without any further conversation, I would like brother Mihr Ali Shah Sahab to come to the stage and say a nath, please. Alhamdulillah, he has been in Bradford, London, Bradford, London, Bradford. And I very khush sadi khush kismat hi hai ki aaj ye the hai.
Subhanallah.
Shah Nawi Sahab baithe hain. Hamza Sahab baithe hain. Mir Hamza baithe hain. Aur ek Aziz Haqqani.
Subhanallah, subhanallah.
Nare takbir. Allahu Akbar.
نعرہ تکبیر
اللہ اکبر
نعرہ رسالت
یا رسول اللہ
نعرہ حیدری
یا علی
جشن میلاد النبی
زندہ باد
He is very tired. I know he's been awake for many days. Ye the hausla afzai kar waste subhanallah alhamdulillah making sure that we
inshallah dosto let's try again nare takbir
allahu akbar allahu akbar
ya rasul allah hadri
ya ali
shahid milad an nabi
zindabad
Come on. Madaniya imama
Allahu
Akbar. Ya Rasulullah.
Ya Rasulullah.
Eid Milad al-Nabi.
Subhanallah, subhanallah. مزہ آیا؟
سبحان اللہ
میں پہلے ایک گل کرتا سا I was talking about the dead who are not worthy of being called the ummah, the ummati. You know, they say that he is like us. They say Rasulullah is like us. Pakistan de vich kehde ya, itthe vi kehde ya, je ik banda itthe Huddersfield de vich faut hove te ohnu Pakistan de vich dafan kita jave te ohnu kehde ya ohdi mitti Pakistan di sigi. Is tarah kehde ya na? That's what they say. Odi mitti utthe di sigi. Ya utthe banda mar jave, itthe dafan hove, kehnde ya odi mitti itthe di sigi. May I, main thonu ek gal puch sakda, may I ask you, where is Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam buried? The place from the house of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, where the Qabr Mubarak is, up to the member of Rasul. Qabr Mubarak tak Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam da member of Rasul, us da na kiya? Jannat da hissa, jannat da tukda. نبی کریم کی مطلب ہے میری گل کرن دا نبی کریم دی جسم نو جڑی مٹی لگی ہے نا او کتے دی ہے
جنت
دا ہے نیو نو انڈرسٹینڈ واٹ ایم ٹرائی ٹو سے آئی ایم ٹرائی ٹو پروو ا پوائنٹ دا سوائل دیٹ واز کلیکٹڈ فار پروفیٹ رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم باڈی واز ٹیکن فرام جنت And you think he is like us? Our souls were taken from India, Pakistan, England. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam soil for the body was taken from
Jannah.
I would like to call. He has come all the way from Birmingham to do a speech. Hazrat Maulana Usman Sahib Naqshbandi. Narae Takbir. Narae Risalat. Narae Haidri. Jashan Eid Milad Nabi. Jashan Eid Milad Nabi.
Sarkar ki amad.
Marhaba.
ਤੁਹਾਡਾ ਕੀ ਖਿਆਲ ਆ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਆਪਣੀ ਮਰਜ਼ੀ ਨਾਲ ਆਏ ਆਪਣੀ ਮਰਜ਼ੀ ਨਾਲ ਨਹੀਂ ਆਏ ਪੂਰੇ ਹਡਰਸਫੀਲਡ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚੋਂ ਉਹ ਬੰਦੇ ਆਏ ਆ ਆਤੇ ਹੈ ਵਹੀ I'm nothing else to say.
Ya re risale.
Ya Rasulullah.
Kya baat hai mashallah.
Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah allazi irtada habibihi fil ardi was samaa. Subhanallah. Was salatu was salamu ala sayyidina wa sayyidil anbiya. محمد المصطفى والمجتبى والمرتضى وعلى آله التقى وصحبه نجوم الهدى وعلماء أمته وأولياء ملته البلدة التقى أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وما أرسلناك إلا رحمة للعالمين صدق الله مولانا العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الأمين الكريم ونحن على ذلك لمن الشاهدين والشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين وقال الله تعالى في القرآن العظيم بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا ومولانا محمد وأصحابه وبارك وسلم وصل عليه All praises to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord, the Cherisher and the Sustainer of the entire creation. Choices, peace, blessings and salutations be upon the noblest of all prophets, Hadrat Muhammad al-Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, who came down into this world as a rahmatan lil alameen, as a mercy unto the entire creation. Respected ulama'i kiram, sa'adat, respected elders and brothers, innocent children, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Usually I don't speak this slow. I am extremely tired. I have two jobs and I'm doing this as well. Out of love for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our being here. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shower His mercy and His blessings upon us. May the nigahe karam of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam be upon us. And may this program be accepted in the court of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is 1:23 in the morning and I believe some of us do have work in the morning. Myself, I have to go work again at 7:30 in the morning, so please don't laugh at me. And we are all lovers here. We are all lovers of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has chosen us to be present here to celebrate the milad of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Respected brothers, the question that is always asked, that why do we celebrate the milad? I am not going to start differentiating topics and all these sort of things. I just want to come down to a very small, minute sort of thing which is between each and every one of us. The reason why we celebrate the milad of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam is to better ourselves as Muslims. Simple. What happens in the time of milad? We recite the Quran. We recite the praises of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We recite the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We recite Na'at, the praises of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. And then we give lectures for our youngsters and for our elders to get hidayah from the life of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. So inshallah today I am here to commemorate, to remember the milad of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, the purpose why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us such a blessed prophet.
Subhanallah.
It was at that time when children, girls were buried alive. It was at that time when women were enslaved, where there was corruption everywhere. It was at that time of the darkness, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us such a light. Gave us such a mercy. That for wallahi, if it wasn't for him, we would not be here today. If it wasn't for him, we wouldn't be sitting in this masjid today. That is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. That surely we have not sent you, but as a mercy unto the entire creation. Not just for us, but for every single thing in this world, for every single thing in this creation, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam as a mercy for us. And what do we learn from this mercy? If we look at our lives today, we see that we are going from bad to worse. Just here up north, last week, there was a brawl of 20 men, all Muslims. all Asians. Is this what the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam taught us? Down where I live in Birmingham, the amount of killing and murder which is taking place, is this what Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam taught us? My brothers, take heed from this. Look at the previous nations and look at our nation, and you will see a very huge difference between the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has upon us and the mercy that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had upon them. I'll give you a simple example. Let's take the Bani Israel. At the time of Hazrat Musa alayhi salam, the Bani Israel, the commandment for the Bani Israel was that at the time of the Sabbath, which was on a Saturday, you are not allowed to catch any fish. Yeah. A very simple commandment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wow. Every Saturday, you are not allowed to catch any fish. But what did these people do? On Saturdays, they used to catch fish. And what did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala do as a punishment for them? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala changed their faces into monkeys.